Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So I hope everyone is recovering from TechEd from a couple of weeks ago. While we were all in Las Vegas helping out at the SAP TechEd hands-on lab, Florian Wall posted a blog post announcing the 22.11 release of SAP BTP ABAP environment. As usual, the latest release comes packed with lots of new features for ABAP development tools, or ADT, and the ABAP RESTful application programming model. But don't forget about all the other new features related to administration, continuous integration and delivery, infrastructure, integration and security, and of course, reuse services. For more information about the specific features in this release, check out Florian's blog post today.
Instructions were released this week for installing the trial version of SAP Build Apps on your own SAP BTP account. The new blog by Bea Pash explains how you can open your own individual pay-as-you-go BTP account and then install the free tier service plan for SAP Build Apps, the former SAP AppGiver. All of this is free. I did the process myself and it worked exactly as the short video explained. But do note that you will have to enter a credit card to create the account, and though it's 5 minutes work to request the account, there is a small delay in getting the account approved and in activating the accompanying identity service, or IAS. Also, such individual accounts are not available in all regions. The free tier version, of course, has a few limitations. It can be used only in one sub-account. The Cloud Functions instance stops when it is not used. You get a maximum of 64 megabytes of storage, and you can only run iOS and Android builds twice per app. A link to the blog is in the description.
Just 2 weeks ago, we wrapped up the major SAP technology event for the year, SAP TechEd. If you missed any of the details from SAP TechEd, of course, you can still go to the SAP TechEd website and catch many of the replays. Also, the main keynotes from day one and day two are available for replay on YouTube on the main SAP channel. Or if you missed the SAP Developer Advocates download session that we gave at the end of day one, I'd really encourage you to check that out. There's some great tech demos designed for developers, a fun recap of the major announcements at SAP TechEd, and the announcement of the Devtoberfest winners. That's available for replay right here on the SAP Developers YouTube channel. Now, there was a ton of announcements at SAP TechEd, so don't blame me if you might have missed a few of them. And there's a couple of key blogs that have done a great job of summarizing some that I want to point out to you here. First, Sebastian Schmidt has an excellent blog that summarizes all the announcements around the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model. And there were a ton of them at TechEd, and he goes into much more detail than what a press announcement or a keynote can cover. So if you're into the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, definitely check out his blog post. There's also another blog post by Anna Marie that summarizes all the BTP innovations and enhancements for professional developers that were announced at TechEd. So if you want a high-level summary of everything professional developer related that came out at TechEd, definitely have a look at her blog post as well.
I quit. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not about me. iQuit is the name of the new SAP HANA Machine Learning Challenge, where you are asked to predict employee churn using SAP HANA Embedded Machine Learning and the dataset provided to you. The challenge started this week, so it is a good moment to join it, to get some hands-on experience and experiment with machine learning with the help of a global team of experts from SAP supporting you through this challenge. The sooner you join, the more time you have to build a winning solution. So, are you in? Come on, don't quit. And as well, I welcome you to check my personal story from expert systems of the 1990s to artificial intelligence of the 2020s. It is behind the second door of the 24 days of community calendar. Links are in the description.
SAP Build Process Automation recently announced a new release, and among the new features, new Google-related SDKs for Google Docs and cloud storage. So you can, for example, create and update Google documents and presentations in your automations. IT admins can now set up self-service for business users to install the new Desktop Agent 3 on virtual machines with a pre-configured configuration. And they can set up batch installations of the agent. And several new features were added to the application itself, such as a new tab to view all your triggers, a way to copy existing projects, the ability to record WebDimPro applications, improvements in capturing SAP GUI applications, and the ability to search for activities within large automations. You can see a whole list of new and updated features in Ishita Mahayan's blog, a link to which I'll put in the description.
Recently, Q4 releases of both SAP Analytics Cloud and SAP Data Intelligence Cloud Edition have been released. There were too many new features to list here, but I would like to highlight ongoing enhancement in the new model and optimized story experience updates in SAP Analytics Cloud, and continuous improvement in generation to operators in data pipelines in SAP Data Intelligence. You might remember a great overview of Gen 2 operators presented during the Oktoberfest too. If you missed them, the link is in the description. So please check blog post published by both product teams and get the full update there.